and sisters who have gathered here this evening. I thank you all for the happy presence you have given me. This evening, I am asked to speak about spiritual astrology. This morning, I was also asked to explain how I came into contact with my master. If you permit me to do it after the lecture, I will do it. And first, I will begin to explain something about spiritual astrology. The word spiritual means something belonging to the spirit. Astrology means the science of light, and in its popular sense, it is the light of the science of the planets. And how, and the science which teaches us how the planets influence us. But according to the definition of the scriptures, it is the science of light in its true sense. Till today, we do not exactly know what light is, though every one of us knows light. It is like a little child tasting a drop of honey. The child knows everything about the substance, but he does not know its name, how it is brought, and how it is prepared, and how it is made available to him. Same thing it is to us about the light. The scientists are speculating about the question, what light is. Is it matter? Is it force? Not yet discovered. It is not yet discovered. But the authors of the scriptures give us that light is a degree of consciousness. It seems to be more reasonable than the speculations of the modern science. By the term light, we know that which illuminates our eye. We have also another light which illuminates our mind. We can call it mental light. There is also another expansion of consciousness which makes us understand things, which makes our consciousness expand into the relatively higher degrees. The ancients meant all these levels of consciousness when they used the term light, and they have described the existence of the science of light, and they called it astrology. The purpose of astrology is also clearly given in the scriptures. Though many people make a confusion about the utility of astrology. In fact, it is popularly understood as a science of prediction, a science which tells us when we are going to be married, and when we are going to get a son, when we are going to get a job, or a betterment in job. Of course, many times we use astrology for this purpose. It is not wrong to use astrology for this purpose, but it is only 1,000th part of our understanding the value of astrology. It is the science is like the light in this room. If I can use the light to eat, it is not wrong. But when I take off the switch and when it is dark in the room, in the night once again, when I wake up, I want to go out, then I may stumble upon a chair and fall down. That means I have not made a better use of light. When I was having light in the room, I would have not only eaten my meal, but also arranged the chairs in the room in such a way that I do not stumble and fall when I walk in darkness. So it indicates that there are better uses of light. Suppose there is a book in the room which makes me understand where there are and where are the switches, where is the table lamp and where is the bed lamp and where are the switches. I would have studied the book before sleep in the new room, because after taking off the light, I have to sleep in darkness, because I have not read the book where the bed lamp is. So it all depends upon how we make the best use of light. This is true with astrology in all its shades of utility. Exactly the same thing has been said in the scriptures about astrology. He says it illuminates the room and makes us know where an object is, makes us know the proper place of every object in the room, and the room is your life. That is what the scriptures say about astrology. It is a boon to see that our life is not a dark room. It is a benediction. So if we see people using astrology for prediction, we cannot say that it is wrong, but we can say only that they make a poor use of a rich subject. The husband of a young couple newly married wonderfully discovers a pleasant truth about his wife and goes to the astrologer to find out if it would be a son or a daughter. Sometimes the astrologer says it is the son or daughter. Sometimes it becomes true. Sometimes it fails. But always it is 50% success. Because there are only two alternatives, either son or daughter. There was a king in the ancient days who was not having a son at all for a very long time. Then at last his wife conceived, and he asked his state astrologer if it was a son or a daughter. The astrologer was in trouble, because in those days if the prediction failed, the astrologer was dismissed from his royal service. So he closed his eyes, went into meditation, opened his eyes and said, "There is a great curse upon you. If something could be predicted about your child, it will die and it will be a miscarriage." "But I shall prove the genuineness of my knowledge of the science of astrology. I will give the prediction on a paper, seal the prediction in a cover and put it at a place. After the child birth, our king can verify it and find it correct." Then there was the child birth. Then the astrologer asked, "Is it the son or daughter?" And the astrologer said, "There is the cover, take it." They took the sealed cover to the king. He opened it and found that it was son. The truth was, the astrologer prepared two sealed covers, placed one cover in one window and another cover in another window. So we have to resort to such methods if we make a wrong use of astrology. It is better whenever an young couple comes and asks if it was a son or daughter, that a clever astrologer gave a clever answer. He said, "There is only one sure way of knowing the fact. That is to wait for a few months." So it needs no astrology. It needs no astrology to know if it would be a son or a daughter. Even we know beforehand, what are we going to do? Are we going to change? Therefore, we need not make such a use for such a science called astrology. According to the vastness of our common sense and finer sense, we can make the better use of the same science. A gentleman from Munich has to go by car to another village and finish some hours work and then return home. And the village exists in the eastern part of his city, towards the east of his city. Early in the morning by 8:30 he started by his car. He travelled the way to his village and finished his work there, took his lunch, took some rest, and in the evening he returned home by car. Another person started in the evening, went there, finished his work, took his supper, slept there, and returned home next morning. What is the difference? For the first one, while going, he had to face the sun. He had to drive his car facing the sun. And when in the evening, he had to face the sun once again and drive his car. To the second one, when he was traveling in the evening, the sun was at his back. And in the next morning, when he was driving home, once again the sun was at his back. The journey is the same. The town and the village are the same, but it is the presence or absence of common sense that makes him the journey a comfort or discomfort. It is only to have such use and such knowledge astrology is given to us. The 12 signs of the zodiac and the planets, first there were seven. There were only seven planets known by man, and then there were nine planets, then 12 planets. And there was a time, according to the scriptures, when man was knowing 33 planets. And now, once again, the modern age, we may discover all the 33 planets and know the true significance of the 33 planets. But whatever it may be, the signs of the zodiac and the planets are given to us by nature as the keyboard of a typewriter or the keyboard of an advanced computer machine. It is for us to undergo proper training to make use of the available data. With the same typewriting machine, the new student commits mistakes. And a businessman types his business correspondence, and a literary man types his literary articles. A scientist makes his articles on science. Whichever subject there is between heaven and earth can be made to transact with people with the same alphabet and with the same keyboard, the typewriter. Similarly, the alphabet of astrology, which we call the zodiac and the planets, forms the fundamental data with which we are made and with which everything on our planet is made and with which all the planets of our solar system are made. The same data indicates everything in the creation. Therefore, it indicates our future also sometimes. For this reason, some people thought that our future has been a sealed book.
Sorry.
That the story of everyone has been written in all detail in the past by the planets. And our life is only a re-narration of already written story. But when we observe the actions of nature, we find that it is not true. Our life is not fated and sealed. We are allowed to have as much independence in our action as is desirable. And the degree of desirability is determined by our own desires. We are made into a self-willed machine and we are allowed to condition ourselves and limit ourselves for reasons of safety and security. And the conditioning is not made by the planets at all. The planets induce tendencies in us, and the tendencies are misused or rightly used by us, because our tendencies form the keyboard of our psychological mechanism. Everyone uses his own psychological computer, feeding either in the correct way or in the incorrect way. Whenever he feeds it in the wrong way, he receives the results in the wrong way, and he follows the wrong directions of himself, and then find the fault somewhere, and once again wipe off the previously feeding data, and once again feed the computer better. This is how nature has arranged. Nature has never made us prisoners of her will, because it has given us a will, and it has given us a language to understand how our will should work. The language of our will is understood by the sun in our horoscope, and our reflection of truth about our will is made to understand by the moon in our horoscope, because the moon indicates the phenomenon of reflection. The same rays of the sun are reflected by moon on this earth, and we understand it as moonlight. Similarly, our mind receives the light of our own will and spirit, and what we call our own ideas and concepts are only the reflected existences of our own truths. But reflection need not always be true. Sometimes it is distorted when we have a wrong angle with the mirror. Sometimes we can see only half of our face when we do not face the mirror properly. And sometimes we do not see the image of the face at all when we place the illumination in the wrong angle from the mirror. If the light in the room is placed behind the mirror, when we face the mirror, we cannot see the image of our face. But if we place the light before our face and place the mirror in a relatively darker place, then we can see the image of our face more clearly. The same is the truth with the use and misuse of our mind. How we are going to use our mind is understood by the position of the moon in our horoscope. If the moon receives an affliction from any other planet, it clearly indicates that there is something wrong in the angle of our mind. But it does not mean that we are ill-fated to have a wrong mind lifelong. It indicates only that we have to take the caution and that we have to receive the proper training to make the mind into the right angle. Unless there is a way to better ourselves, there is no use at all of a science like astrology. When everything is fated and sealed, it is the same if we know or we do not know it at all. Sometimes it is better not to know, because we begin to react wrongly upon the fact if we know a little earlier. In fact, in such a case, there is more harm than help by a science like astrology. But the seers of the centuries of all nations have given us the science of astrology with all veneration and faith. No one gives us a subject which has no use at all. And they have promised us how the ancients used the science. The forces of nature are working on the universal scale, And the forces and intelligences of our earth planet are working for all the living beings of this earth. They do not work individually, separately. The planets do not come to every one of us and ask what you want. But they are ready to cater everyone in a fine way. See, the railway train does not come to every house and ask you to get into it to take your journey. But at the same time, it is serviceable to everyone who wants to take a journey. There is something we have to do, and there is something which the train does for us. When we do our duty properly, when we go to the railway station in time and reserve our ticket with the railway people in time and get into the train safely before the train begins to move, then the train takes us safely to the destination. So it is a fact that we have to do something in our life. And it is a fact that then only the planets are going to help us. An young man went to the astrologer and asked when I would be married. The astrologer made an analysis of the horoscope and said, next year by March you will be married. The young man slept in his house until the end of March and went to the astrologer and asked him, I am not married. He thought that the planets would come to his door and knock his door and bring a beautiful dame for him. It will not be the case at all. The planets help us in our expansion. We should begin to feel how our expansion will be. At every step, whenever we feel the need of our expansion, there is the help of the planets which makes us expand. Whenever we have a thought, there is the external activity that is directly related to the thought. Similarly, as long as there is an urge from inside for us to expand, there is the work of the planets continuously influencing us in a positive way, making our consciousness expand into the truth more and more, more and more into its wisdom aspect. So the planets will prepare what we want. We are to eat the supper. That is how we have to understand the real utility of astrology. And when we try to understand the 12 signs and the functions of the planets, we have our tendencies as planets within our psychological unit, and we have on this earth the forces of the planetary nature of the earth, which are giving their magnetic touch to our tendencies. Imagine that your tendencies are like balls of iron, and the planetary tendencies that are working through your earth globe are like the various magnets. When we have iron, little iron balls in our pocket, when there is a magnet in our hand, when we begin to move the magnet near the iron balls will be magnetized from within outside. When the magnet is working from outside towards us, this is how the planets work with us. We have our love and hatred, our likes and dislikes, our jealousies and suspicions, our fears. All these things work as blockings in us and limitations in us. But when the planets from outside are working, these blockings are gradually giving way, and when the time comes, these inimical forces that are working in us, they begin to speak with us. They will remove the horrible masks from their heads and they smile from within. They say, this is only a drama. This is only to make you mature, to transfer, to make a desired transformation in you. Unless we play this drama, the limitations in you will not be removed. You are like a little bud. The petals are folded within yourself, and all the petals are only green, but no beautiful colors. There is no fragrance. But we want to remind you that your petals should expand and blossom into a flower. Take the required colors which make world delightful, and form the honey drops which we call the maturity of the soul. That is how the planets indicate us. The incidents in our life which we understand as good and bad, they have only one effect upon us, good effect. We should not understand that good incidents have good effect and bad incidents have bad effect.